We are so happy to have this chance to share the word of God. I will pray, then we begin. Father, thank you for this moment. It is our pleasure to listen to the word of God. Father, it's different when we have the word of God and when we don't have. That's why you always prepare the chance for us to follow and listen from your word. So we hope that in this time you also bless our heart through the word. In the name of Jesus we pray everything. Amen. So we are going to share from the book of John chapter
8.
From verse 1. John chapter 8 from verse
1.
But Jesus went to the Mount Olives. Now early in the morning he came again into the temple, and all the people came to him, and he sat down and taught them. Then the scribes and Pharisees brought to him a woman caught in the adultery, and when they had set her in the midst, they said to him, "Teacher, this woman was caught in the adultery in the very act." Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned, but what do you say? This they said, testing him that they might have something of which to accuse him. But Jesus stopped down and wrote at the ground with his finger, as though he did not hear. So when they continued asking him, he raised himself up and said to them, "He who is without sin among you, let him throw a stone to her first." And again he stopped down and wrote on the ground. Then those who had it been convicted by their conscience went out one by one, beginning with the oldest, even to the last. And Jesus was left alone, and the woman standing in the midst. When Jesus had raised himself up and saw no one but the woman, he said to her, "Woman, where are those accusers of yours? Has no one condemned you?" He said, "No one, Lord." And Jesus said to her, "Neither do I condemn you. Go and sin no more." Yeah, thank you. We have read up to verse 11. I heard that there was a CEO who had a very huge company. This man was getting old and old. So he started to think who will be in his behalf when he dies. So he started to think among his workers. Who can do and work according to my heart. So there are many people he could trust among his workers. But he wanted to change them so that he can really see who is trustworthy to left with his company. So one day he took some seeds and he cooked them. So when his workers were going home in the evening, so one evening he called them and he gave each of them one seed to go and plant it. So he told them, you go and you plant this seed, and when it grows up, please you bring it to me. So they went and planted those seeds accordingly. So since these seeds were from the boss, they had to take care of them carefully. Because everyone received, they had to think that once I don't care this seed well, I will be fired. I'm sure that the boss will see my heart through this seed. Yes, this is how they received the heart of their master. So they went and they planted at their home and they started to water this seed. So they waited 1 week, but the seeds couldn't sprout out. So, but they kept on watering and taking care of them. So some of them, they started to put them in the shelter so that the sun may not destroy them. So anyway, after 2 weeks, they waited, but nothing was coming out. But still, they kept on watering and taking care. And the third week, nothing. 1 month, nothing. So finally, they started to change their minds. Why this seed is not coming out? So at their working place, this was the conversation among themselves. How about you? Is your seed sprout out? No, nothing is working. So another one was asking his neighbor in this way. So after two months, nothing was coming out. So when they saw it like that, some workers, they started to think how they have to please their master. So they are worried that maybe they didn't take care accordingly. So this is how they started to think how they can replace that seed with another seed. So they did it like that, according to their thoughts. So when they replaced that seed, the seed started to sprout out. So they watered them, they took care of them, they fertilized them, so they grow up very well. But the time came to show their boss what they did. So after 4 months, they had to show their boss what they did. So everyone had to present his fruit. Yes, this is how it happened, because one day the boss prepared that ceremony. So early in the morning, all workers except one, they came at their working place with their seed. So they started to present to their boss one by one. So from those who are next to the CEO, they started to present. And the CEO was asking one by one, how did you do? I went home and I planted in a very nice place and I started to take care of it. And after some time I saw it coming up. So I was happy with that. So one by one was presenting this way. So but there was one worker who had nothing to show. But when this worker saw others presenting very nice seeds, he was trembling in his heart. Because he was thinking that finally my boss is going to fire me. How will it be my life? I got this job by chance. Now my boss will not endure, will cast me away. So he was very fearful to see what others were presenting before the CEO. So when all finished except one, the boss told him to stand up. So he asked him, what's wrong with you? What did you do? So can't you show what you did? So within 4 months, what you did? What did you do? So he stood up, he told his boss, boss, the seed you gave me, I took it at home and I planted it and I started to take care of it. But nothing worked. So even though I did it, I did my best, but nothing could work out. So I don't know why, but that is how it happened to me. So now it was the turn for their boss to speak. So the boss told them, now you see I'm getting old. So I need someone to replace me. So when I was thinking this way, so I didn't just trust anyone, I just wanted to examine you. So this is how the seed I gave you are cooked. So but now I can I was surprised when I saw many of you coming back with the sprouted seeds. So except one, he came with empty handed. So it means he is only one who is trustworthy. So the rest of you, you are not trustworthy. So this is how he told them, from now, this is the CEO of this company. So the all workers were astonished. Because that is the day for them to discover and realize the heart of their soul. They are so shameful in his eyes. So as you know, the cooked seed cannot sprout out. So it is impossible. So the reason why this only worker, he presented nothing, is because he planted it and he waited, but nothing came out. So now he came before his boss with the heart of the boss. So the boss knew that this seed will not grow up. But the rest of others, they went and they lied to his boss, to their boss. So what I want to say is this. When we read the Bible, we can see that in the beginning God gave the law. So when God they gave the law, so we can see two kinds of people. So there are people who can discover the heart of God through the law, but there are others who cannot discover the heart of God. So people who cannot discover the heart of God, they come before God saying that they kept the law. We have kept the law. But what is the heart of God? So the heart of God, he didn't give the law thinking that people will keep the law. Because God knew very well the weakness of human
beings.
So the heart of God was that human being cannot keep the law. But even though God knew that people cannot keep the law, He gave them the law. But God is surprised when people come before Him saying that we have kept the law. We did everything well. We loved our neighbors. We loved God. We do everything according to the law. So how do God think when He listen people saying like this? How do God see people when He sees them with this kind of heart? So God cannot accept them because of that. So why God gave us the law though we cannot keep the law? So the reason why God gave the law, so it's because God wanted people to discover their weaknesses so that they can only depend on God. So before Jesus came in this world, people they used to be taught that they have to keep the law. You have to keep the law. If you don't keep the law, you will not be loved by God. God will not accept you. So this is how this woman in the book of John chapter 8 was living. As she was taught that you have to keep the law. Don't commit adultery. So from her birth, she was listening this kind of message. That is what the reason why in the beginning she tried to hold herself for not committing adultery. So in the beginning she used to think that she will succeed. But finally she couldn't succeed because she was caught one day in the very act. So when she was caught, this is when she realized that, now I'm caught. I was thinking that I will not be caught. So from the beginning I used to think that I will not commit adultery. And the next step I thought that even if I may do it, I may not be caught. And now I'm caught. And this is the end of my life. So we can see that all of us we are like this. But sometimes people they think that they are different like the, from this woman. You see, this woman was caught by the Pharisees and the scribes. So how was the heart of Pharisees and the scribes? So I'm sure the heart of these people, they used to think that they have kept all law according to the heart of God. So they used to think that they are God believers. They used to think that they love God. So this is the reason why they had started to condemn this woman. But before Jesus, these people were not in the position to criticize and condemn this woman. Because to Jesus, all of them, they are saying like this woman. So all of them, they are supposed to die according to the law. They have to perish. If they trust themselves to keep the law, so they have to be like this woman. But when they stood before Jesus, so they could think that this woman is very evil. This woman was caught in the very act. What do you say about her? Moses told us to kill this woman with a stone. Such woman. So what do you say about her? So they are very confident for themselves. So but when Jesus started to speak, he showed them, even them, they are not different from this woman. Actually, this is the work of Jesus to come in this world. Because before Jesus came, we can see all people, they trust themselves to keep the law. Because this is only teachings people could listen. Every time, every morning, every evening, they could be reminded the law. This is only what they knew. But when Jesus came, he started to speak things which are different from their former teachings. Because what Jesus came to do is to make people to discover that there are those who cannot keep the law. There are those who failed to keep the law. So Jesus came to help people to change their mind to the law. Because if they realize that, even though we have trusted ourselves thinking that we keep the law, so they can change and believe someone else knows the law. Because actually when someone is believing, he's trying to believe in God based on the law, this person is relying upon himself. Because everything, it is the work of man. Everything is the one who has to do it. So it means there is no help of God in the life of this person. But problem in the mind of people, when they live like this, they think that this is the way to believe in God. Even though they have no relationship with God, they think that we are godly people. So Jesus was coming to make people discover that law didn't come for you to keep. But law came to show you that you are a failure. You are miserable. You are only a person to depend on God. So God has to do everything for you. Not you to do everything by yourself. This is what Jesus was coming to do in this world. So if people do not listen to the message of Jesus carefully, so they may think that Jesus is against Moses. But we can see that the reason why God sent Moses before Jesus. So it was one way to make people believe in Jesus. Because if people discover that we fail to keep the law, they can discover that there is another way for us to be justified. So when they realize that there is another way to be justified, these people, they are no longer trusting and believing themselves. So this woman realized that I lived my life trusting myself. Because since her birth, she couldn't have grace in her heart. So until Jesus came in the life of this woman, she had never received any rest in her heart, even one single day. But I want to show you when this woman met Jesus. So when this woman met Jesus, there is nothing special did for this woman. Because what Jesus did is to make these Pharisees and the scribes realize that you are also sinners like this woman. So when they saw that they are also sinners, they became speechless. So this is the beginning of Jesus talking to this woman. So when this woman heard and listened the word of Jesus, she was so happy because on verse 10, when Jesus had raised himself up and saw no one but the woman, he said to her, "Woman, where are those accusers of yours? Has no one condemned you?"
Yes,
so it means you and those people, there is no difference. So they are not worthy to condemn you. They are not supposed to condemn you because they are not different from
you.
So go and I do not condemn you. So if Jesus do not condemn you, who will condemn you? So if Jesus is not criticizing you, who will criticize you? So if Jesus says, "I do not condemn you," so it means in the eyes of God, you are okay, you are fine. So maybe you can say that, how you do not condemn you, yet I committed sin. You may say to Jesus that, why and how you do not condemn me, yet I committed sins. So who is right between you and Jesus? Imagine if this woman insisted saying, I don't agree with you because I was caught in the very act of adultery. So how can you say that you don't condemn me? So it means I don't have sin? It means I'm okay, I'm fine? So do you think I'm holy? Do you think I'm righteous? No. I don't agree with you. Because these people dragged me to you after being caught in the very act. So if this woman insisted on this, so it means she is rejecting the word of Jesus. But if this woman rejects the word of Jesus, who will justify this woman? If he is rejecting the word of Jesus, so it means she wants to be justified by her own works. She is waiting the day she will stop committing sin. But this day will not come in the life of this woman. Even if she tried to stop sin from her birth, but this woman didn't stop sinning until she was caught in a very act. So what can make this woman have hope and peace in our heart is the word of Jesus. I do not condemn you, go and sin no more. So where are those Pharisees and scribes? So they had to bow before Jesus. Jesus, we didn't know that we are also sinners like this woman. When you caught this woman, you thought that there is a big difference between her and us. So now, since we are before you, we have realized that we are also sinners. We are supposed to be stoned. Thank you, Jesus. So this was supposed to be the beginning for their salvation. So the same message this woman heard from Jesus was the same message these people were supposed to hear. You go, I do not condemn you. Even Jesus could not condemn those people who ran away. But where are them to listen this message?
ariko si bari bari hehe kugira ngo bumve ubutumwa.
So only this woman was able to hear this voice of Jesus.
Umugore niwe yari gusa ashobora kumva ijwi rya Yesu.
She was so happy and joyful.
Yarishimye cyane anezerewe.
When she was in the way going home,
ubwo iri mu nzira atashye,
she was singing and dancing. She was only praising Jesus. She couldn't imagine how this miracle may happen in her life. Because only death was waiting this woman. She was waiting to be stoned. But amazing thing, she was able to be released when she stood before Jesus. So these Pharisees and the scribes, they could think that we are correct ourselves. This is how they went away thinking. Though we saw our sins, but we correct ourselves. So this is how they went home thinking. But Jesus kept on insisting, showing them, you cannot correct yourself. You are corrupt. When you read the book of John chapter 5, verse 39. John chapter 5, verse 39. Bible says, you search the scriptures, for in them you think you have eternal life. That these are they which testify of me.
Murondora byanditswe kuko mwibwira ko muri byo arimo mufite ubugingo buhoraho kandi ari byo bimpamya.
But you are not willing to come to me that you may have life.
Nyamara nanze kuza aho ndi ngo muhabwe ubugingo.
Verse 42 says, but I know you, that you do not have the love of God in you.
Murongo 22 ngo ariko mwebwe ndabazi yuko mudakunda Imana mu mitima yanyu.
Yes, Jesus knew them very well.
Yes, he was neza.
So you don't love God in your heart.
Ntabwo mukunda Imana mu mitima yanyu.
But how do they used to think? We love God very much.
Dukunda Imana cyane.
We love God.
Dukunda Imana.
We have much love towards God.
Dufite Imana urukundo rwinshi.
This is how they used to think. So, but Jesus is saying, since you don't know yourself, you are not coming to me so that you may have life. Because everyone who may get life is one who comes to me. But you see, instead of coming to Jesus, they are running away from Jesus. But Jesus is life himself. Means if they run away from Jesus, they are running away from life, eternal life. So they went home and they started to correct themselves. They started to repent. They started to revise the law. They started to change many things in their lives. After some period of time, they thought, now there is a change in our lives. For now, God can accept us. But Bible shows that no one can be accepted only through Jesus. So this woman could not be accepted far from Jesus. But when she came to Jesus, she was able to be accepted. So this is my story, this is your story. Because Bible is asking you, are you in the group of these Pharisees and the scribes, or you are in the group of this woman who was caught in the act? So this is the reason why this story in the John chapter 8 is in this way. So Bible wants us to see and know where we are standing now. Not where you will stand tomorrow or not where you were standing yesterday. Where you are standing now in your heart. Where you are standing in your spiritual life. Are you trying to correct things in your life, like these Pharisees and the scribes? Or you want to receive the grace of Jesus like this woman who was caught in the act? So do you still have the excuses in your life?
Uracyafite urwitwazo mu buzima bwawe?
Oh, you are this like this woman who is speechless.
Cyangwa umeze nk'umugore utarufite icyo kuvuga.
So this is you. This is you are the one who knows where how your heart is before God. But the best choice is to be like this woman. Because all of us before Jesus we are like this woman. But the thoughts of these Pharisees and the scribes, they are only those who are trying to separate and to bring this separation between them and this woman. Because they are thinking that if we try our best, we cannot be like this woman. But this woman was able to receive much grace from Jesus. She was so happy and joyful. No one was happy as this woman was. So do you want to have a great happiness in your heart like this woman? You have to be in the shoes of this woman. If you are not in the shoes of this woman, you will be in the shoes of Pharisees and the scribes. So if you keep holding your thoughts, you will avoid the word of God. So if even though Jesus may tell you that all your sins were forgiven, so things, since you have confidence in you thinking that you can change your life, you will reject this word of Jesus. So Jesus died for this woman who was caught in the act of adultery. Jesus died for such people. Jesus didn't die for righteous people. Jesus didn't die for people who can live spiritual life very well. Jesus didn't die for people who don't commit sin. Jesus died for people who only sinners who broke the law. Those who cannot keep the law. Jesus died for such people. But many times as we go to churches, we think that we can keep the law very well. So when we stand before God thinking that we kept the law, to God we are liars. Because the law God gave, the law human being cannot keep. We don't need to stand before God like the workers who stood before their master showing him the sprouted seed. Even though he gave them the corrupted seed, so they tried to show him the seeds which are okay. So through this he was able to see theirs. So this is how many people they are living spiritual life. So God cannot accept such people. As this CEO accepted this worker who was before him with empty hand, so likewise God can only accept those who come before him with nothing. Those who did nothing. Those who failed in everything. But many people, they want to come before Jesus with many fruits. So God cannot accept such people. So those who come to him with empty handed, they are those who can be justified.
They
are those who can receive what God is trying to give us. So I hope we know our true position before God. I hope we know the clear heart of God towards human beings. So thank you so much. I will end up here. Let me pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, thank you. Father, it's not that you want us to work very hard.
Data igikristo ushaka dukora cyane.
But when we are deceived by our thoughts, when we are caught by our thoughts, we think that He wants us to work very hard. All people who think that they can be justified through the law, they work very hard. But even though they work very hard, they cannot be justified. So if they keep holding these thoughts, however, they will perish. But the reason now I keep sharing the word of God is to make people realize that only grace can justify human being. So we thank you, Lord. You keep giving us this grace to share the word of God. In the name of Jesus, we pray everything. Amen. So thank you so much. See you next time.